We're going to start this morning with our Commitment 2012 coverage. It is Election Day, of course, here in Maine, primary day. Today, voters are going to head to the polls and narrow down the candidates that will appear on the ballot this November.
And that includes the race to fill Senator Olympia Snowe's Senate seat. News 8's Dave Guthro joins us live now with a closer look for us. Good morning, Dave.
Well, good morning, guys.
Joining us here on the desk.
Yeah, it should be an exciting day, right? Creeping up here. The polls opening in just a matter of time now, a couple of hours away here. Shaping November's ballot. These primaries will, of course, the high-profile race certainly among those trying to snag a spot on the ballot to fill Senator Olympia Snowe's seat in the Republican primary. Scott Danbois, Attorney General Bill Schneider, Secretary of State Charlie Summers, Rick Bennett, State Senator Deborah Plowman, and State Treasurer Bruce Poliquin will square off. And on the Democratic side, the candidates include State Senator Cynthia Dill, Matt Dunlap, State Representative John Hink, and Ben Pollard. Of course, as you've said all morning long, voter turnout expected to be very low today. According to the Secretary of State's office, the number of requests for absentee ballots this year is significantly lower than it has been in past June primaries. In fact, Mary Ellen Fitzgerald with Critical Insight says that polling done by her company shows voter confusion.
If people don't know a lot of the candidates, or they don't have an investment in this, or they think that there's a foregone conclusion coming in the general, they're just not going to vote.
And of course, talking about this Senate race, I think we talked about the debate, like the elephant in the room was the person that was not there at the debate.
And you asked those questions, too. I mean, Angus King has so many supporters out there, and the fact that he and the other independents are going to be on the ballot on November 6th, regardless, the motivation for Democrats and Republicans who are going to support him isn't there today. And they're going to wait until the general election.
But there are some other independents that turned in their paperwork, three other ones.
That's
right.
Tell us
a little bit about them.
Yeah, the deadline for independent candidates to get their signatures in was 8 days ago on June 4th. And as you can see on the screen, four independents submitted those signatures. Governor Angus King, of course, in addition to that, Tea Party activist Andrew Ian Dodge, Yarmouth Town Council Chairman Steve Woods, and Danny Dalton of Brunswick. And again, those candidates will take on the Republican and Democratic winners from today's primary. So you'll have six candidates to choose from on November 6th.